international festival that started, this event that started in France, and Randolph for the past 5 years has been making a big thing of it. So we partnered with Vincent Freeman from Underground Recording Studios and Jess Wilkinson of the White River Craft Center, and we have over 10 hours of music all day, all around town.
Thank you. Such beautiful places with people so beautiful as yourselves. We are a two-part duo.
Venezolana y música de los Montes Apalaches.
And we do a mix of Venezuela and Appalachian folk music.
Somos Larry y yo.
We are Larry and Joe.
Larry soy yo.
Larry soy yo. No, I am Larry. No, I am Joe. Translation's not working.
A ver, vamos a hacer un tema de un gran compositor venezolano conocido como Simón Díaz, el tío Simón.
We're going to do one now by a great Venezuelan composer by the name of Simón Díaz, affectionately known as Uncle Simon. Yo Simón.
Para todos ustedes, mi iglesia.
Thank you. Thank you.
un tema compuesto por Joe.
So this next one was composed by Joe.
De sus composiciones es mi favorita.
And of his compositions, this is my favorite.
Esta canción se convierte en una parte muy especial de mí. El día que la escuché, porque estaba tan cargada sentimentalmente que aunque no entendía nada del idioma, me quebrantó y me hizo llorar.
This song became a very important part of my being because the day that I first heard it, I didn't understand a word of it because of the language barrier, but it was so emotionally charged that it brought me to tears.
Y para mi sorpresa, cuando busqué el video oficial en la red, consigo que tiene traducción en español, subtítulos.
And surprisingly, when I looked for the official music video, I found that it was subtitled in Spanish.
Para mí fue importante porque el momento que iba escuchando la letra era como que me iba convirtiendo en el personaje principal de la canción.
And that was impactful for me because as I listened to it, I felt as if I were becoming the subject of the song.
Solo pensaba en mi pequeña hija Letty que la traje de solo 3 años en tierra país.
And I can only think of my little daughter Leticia that I brought to this country at the age of 3.
En medio de todo eso solo me quedaba a rezar porque no pase a ningún niño más de este gran país.
And amidst all that, all I could do was pray that something like this doesn't happen to another child in this great country.
Para ustedes, espero que lo disfruten tanto como yo. The Dreamer.
Hope you enjoy it. It's called The Dreamer. This is one that I wrote for my friend Moises Serrano. Moises is a DACA recipient from Yadkin County, North Carolina. He was brought to the States as a baby. And is almost 40 years old, still doesn't have a pathway to citizenship. And immigration reform is something we advocate for, obviously, because Larry himself is an asylum seeker in the perpetual USCIS limbo, waiting for their case to be reviewed. They put their case in 2017, 6 years later, they're still waiting, and have to renew TPS, temporary protective status, every 8 to 10 months. So it's a big pain in the butt. Anyway, this is in solidarity with the migrant community, which we are very blessed to have in North Carolina, to the tune of going on a fourth of the state population at this point from Latin America. This is Moises' story. I use his anglicized name, Moses, with his permission, and it's called The Dreamer. Shepherds would roam so harsh a land, clear the sun beats down like hellfire. Bones mark the path clear across the sand, forlorn souls upon them walking. Thank you. next song we're going to do for you is very important for you. Even if you don't believe so.
Este tema es nuestro tema promocional de nuestro álbum discográfico.
Because this is the title track off of our debut album.
Que hoy lo van a tener a disposición para ya en la
mesita. Which is available for purchase at the table in the lobby.
Y este tema lleva por nombre Nuevo South Train.
That's right, and this song and the album are called Nuevo South Train. And if you're wondering what the Nuevo South is, well... Thank you. can you hear us?
Yes.
That was the word. We're going to rattle off a couple of Venezuelan numbers.
Thank you.
waltz from 1915. And that second composition we just played was written by Latin. It's called El Golpe de Gaza, which means something like the blue heron stall.
Y es una canción que ha recorrido el mundo entero en diversos idiomas y estilos musicales.
And it has been around the world in diverse musical styles and languages.
Esta canción obtuvo para el folclore llanero de Venezuela el primer premio Latin Grammy.
It also won the first Latin Grammy for Venezuelan folk music.
Hoy lo vamos a hacer para todos ustedes el estilo de Latino.
We're going to do it today for y'all in Larry and Joe style.
Para que lo disfruten, caballo viejo.
Hope you enjoy it. It's called caballo viejo, which means old horse. For any old horses that might be amongst them. So Larry's going to help us get in the mood by making some horse sounds, which he's really good at. Of course, he grew up around horses. How about an old horse? Is caballo viejo? Okay. And how about a young person? Caballo joven. Y'all feel a horsey yet?
Yeah.
Not a single name. Come on, get
thank you. Thank you.
This next song is a co-write that we did with an amazing pedal steel player of the sacred steel tradition. Sacred steel is it's a tradition, it's a church music, African-American church music, in which instead of the organ or the piano, they use the pedal steel, sacred steel. And our buddy Deshaun Hickman from Mount Airy, North Carolina, is a great exponent of that style, of that tradition. We wrote this song with him. I wrote the first verse, Lowry wrote the second verse, and Deshaun wrote the third. We're going to do it without Deshaun, because he's not here, obviously, but keep in mind that these are not our words, but we vouch for them, and we like to sing them with Deshaun's permission. It's pretty self-explanatory. This song is called Border Road.
We can build it up tall.
Alright, so this next one is one that I wrote for Lyle about his favorite food, which is called cachapa. Cachapa is like a sweet corn pancake. It's cooked on a hot hibachi style grill. It's served with handmade cheese and, in Larry's case, fried pork. It's his favorite fruit in the entire world. In order to keep a strict diet, he eats fried pork. It's also part of his Greek profile. Greek god status. Anyway, he likes cachapa so much that I wrote a song for him called Larry's Cachapa. And if you wouldn't mind, help sing the callback voices. For those of you that were in the song, it's the sing-along workshop, you're welcome to sing all of it with us. But those of you who weren't in the workshop, you can just sing the callbacks. We'll teach them to you. It goes like this.
Mire la cara alegre que tiene cachapa, ya comió, ya comió!
Okay, so what I'm saying is, look at this happy face he has. He just ate a chapa. And you have to say,
he just ate it.
Which is ya comió. Ya comió.
Mire la cara alegre que tiene cachapa, ya comió. Ya comió. Mire la cara alegre que tiene cachapa, ya comió. Ya comió.
That's it. So the second chorus, you have four callback choruses on. So wow us with your prowess and enjoy yourselves. We're going to do it. Love to catch up.
Thank you.
seeing us, we've come to the last song of the evening. I'd like to introduce my compañero, Yaki, the guy playing all this stuff and singing his arse off from Monagas, Venezuela. This is Larry Mayorin.
This is my brother, Twin. Joe Cruz de Carolina del Norte, Winston Salem.
Get up and shake your rump and go back home.